almost miss out the middleman and try and find the child themselves. We have had provision for a number of years, whether it be my parent booklets, and this is a step further in terms of doctors in the driving seat. Clearly, with appropriate controls, because if you're expecting the doctor, it's been later on in the process of all the checks that we have taken. So, just a little bit about what this means for Wirral. Fostering production actually means recruiting some. Special foster parents who are prepared to take some of the risks in having a, often a baby, placed with them, buried straight from hospital, with a view to them becoming that child's adopters, when still remains some uncertainty about whether the natural parent changes their mind, or whether there will be an extended family make them forward wanting to adopt. So, with a small number of children, strong time. these actually went live on the 1st of September this year. So the legislation places a great emphasis on the needs of individual children and people and their families. So the aspirations that are set within this legislation are in exactly the same way as the aspirations for children who don't have special educational needs or disabilities, that they can achieve the very best that they can do. We aspire for them to achieve their full potential. So the legislation sets out that young people and parents are involved in the design and delivery of services, the joint commissioning arrangement should be in place for these children with the council and health services. Much greater cooperation between the local authority and partners. You have to publish your own offer, setting out what is available to children and families in a very easily accessible way. On the 1st of September. Significant change is to introduce, to remove statements from the 1st of September. So new children who previously removed the statement, that is replaced by something called an education, health and care plan. And there's a transition period for 3 years for children with existing statements on birth . For me, this represents one of those significant changes, because if you think of a statement, it's like a flat statement of fact, whereas an education, health and care plan infers there's a team around the youngster and a positive contribution to that young person's plan, from certainly those three statutory departments. Forming a statement felt very much like an education statement, and people asked to post information through. And then finally, implementation of personal budgets that may be requested by parents on the conclusion of the plan. We've some small examples we've been trying. We've got a family where the parent wanted to keep the old taxi firms, we changed contracts in the council, because the taxi driver knew the child. And so we give that parent the amount of money that proportion of how much we would spend on the contract. Managed to persuade the taxi driver to pay the old rent. So she's using that personal budget to give an element of the care plan that is right for the child. What we're doing in Wirral, set up this, we published an offer. Wirral Family Forum, a group of parent carers, worked on that offer with people. We are doing education health and care plans now. We have got the personal digital policy which we've put into colour. There's lots of training. Number of people from schools, from health, from the local authority. Parent carers came together for some training last week with a number of solicitors and put together again in December. And we've increased the size of the special education needs team with colleagues from the social care background, which is helping. To meet some of the demand, because we've got a small grant that's coming from the government. And we have a really joint from the University of Wellbeing, who's more of a practitioner who will input formal looked after with foster carers will now be able to stay put surrounded with their foster carer until they're 21 years of age. Nationally, we're thinking about flooding arrangements for this. I don't think we need inundated with these children, so not our key to leave, but thinking of our own children, living home and that being into 18 is not actually what happens. So the facility to do this is really important. And any local authority has a requirement to have a virtual school and a teacher. We've had one in Wirral for a number of years, just a primary and secondary one at the moment, and they're people or a person who, under their purview, is all the looked after children, and they have responsibility for making sure they have good and better education and their needs are being met. So they can walk into any school and say, as a virtual head, this is not good enough, and I am all emotionally happy that I'm going to do this. So, that's it.
Thank you, Julia, for your takes for that. Comments, questions? No? Everybody happy? Clear? We're going through on that? Okay. So do all of these measures that you went through, are they all in operation from now?
Yes. Some we've kind of been moving up to, but the day we're starting, the last set of dates was 1st of September, and yes, and
great, okay, thank you, Julia. I know you have to do things, so thanks for that. Okay, right, excellent. So that takes us then on to item seven, Wirral's Pharmaceutical Needs Assessment, which Fiona, I think you're going to do.
Thank you.
thanks Fiona. Comments, questions? Phil?
Kevin will probably tell me if I've gone off on a tangent, which previously happens. How does this system cope with what I have seen happening on the TV systems? That is, where there's a male or a male needs and stuff like that. But sending this to her, you can stay dead or prescriptions from us, and we're the pharmacists, and the approaches that say, please don't sign up these people, because we need a local pharmacy. How do you assess that?
So we're being asked to note the progress to date on this and to approve the proposed timescales for consultation. Can we do that? Yeah, okay, excellent. Right, so we're going to go back to item 6, which is update on child sex exploitation in Wirral. I think it's a bit of double act, Claire, but Claire, and then Simon Garner, welcome Simon, our corporate safeguarding manager. Do you want to come up here? So, are you going to sort of do this between the two? Okay, sorry to you.
Thanks, Chair. So, the report that you have presented to you this afternoon outlined the issues and recommendations that were set out in the report that was written by Professor Alex Jay, following the inquiry into the Wellbeing Council and the issues that were
balance right between perhaps challenging attitudes and approaches to this issue, but at the same time supporting people who perhaps don't yet have the confidence to tell us about a particular situation. So they might all recognise something from what they see in the media, but actually taking that bold step of referring to social care is a big one, and most of our referrals tend to be from the more well-versed agencies as professionals and health professionals such as the police and ourselves, rather than other parts of the community and other businesses and services. Along then in the report to we've talked about the relationships at a strategic level, and hence why the protocol's on the agenda, because it is an important one, this particular topic, for the relevant boards to understand how we come together, work together on these things. And it particularly highlights in Wirral what sorts of approaches we have currently, what we do when a child is referred with a concern about child sexual exploitation. So it talks about the type of meeting, the nature of professionals that are involved. So just as an example, and you probably heard of something called the multi-agency safeguarding hub. The hub's now live, and that's different agencies coming together with information, sharing information at a high level in some detail, so that we're better placed to respond to a safeguarding issue. And we had a case of CSE recently where the initial presentation was very much about a young person, a 15-year-old girl, who was putting on the internet availability that she was providing to older men for inappropriate services and things, and suggesting that there was a charge for this. And of course, people intervened very much in how they could support the parents initially, how the school could support the young person. When it was brought into the safeguarding hub, the level of detail that agencies were able to share revealed that there was quite a high level of drug misuse from her older brother, and quite a lot of sexual activity from her older brother in the home. And it turned out that he was setting her up really to do this. This wasn't a journey she'd initiated herself. And knowing that that was a dimension we needed to tackle, you know, altered obviously what our intervention was and how we worked with the family. So that's just giving you a flavour of how things can work and how they can work well. And for those children that do come into the service, we do have a good, solid multi-agency response. I say that with some confidence. The issue, however, outside of those children who are referred are the unknowns out in the community and our knowledge of how we get to learning about them and making sure that we have the same assured response as the children that we know about. So then we've gone on to write about some of the things that we're going to do in response to the rather inquiry. And these are strengthening some of the current actions that we have in place already. So we do lots of training already. We do lots of training around our child sexual exploitation across the partnership. And it's very good training. There was some of it in here the other day when I called in. And we had some really good discussions. But we don't necessarily reach some of our young people sufficiently, who may not understand themselves what it is that they're on the edge of being involved in or what they are actually involved in. They may interpret it, of course, quite differently. So we've got a theatre company called Chelsea's Jews, who is a fantastic production, very powerful, very much pitched to young people. We're going to be going into schools over 20 performances over 2 weeks in February, so we've had to coordinate with this with a bit with the school's agenda. We'd like to do it a bit sooner. But it's a really good team. We do a little workshop afterwards. We're going to have people there to support any young people.